In this video, we're going to be looking at standard form. So what are standard form numbers? Well, they're a concise way of writing very large or very small numbers. For example, instead of that really large number, we could say it is estimated that there are 1 times 10 to the power of 24 stars in the known universe. Or instead of this really small number, we can say that the radius of a proton is 8.4 times 10 to the negative 16 meters, according to the latest measurements. Now, standard form numbers appear in a particular form, A times 10 to the K, where A and K are numbers, but also where A needs to be at least 1, but also less than 10. And that's those parts of the standard form numbers. And K, the power of 10, needs to be an integer. And that's those parts of the standard form numbers. And note from the second case that it can be a negative integer as well as being a positive integer. And let's also remember what these numbers mean. So 1 times 10 to the power of 24 with the positive power of 10, that means 1 multiplied by 10 24 times. Or 8.4 times 10 to the negative 16 with the negative power of 10, that means 8.4 divided by 10 16 times. Another important thing is this condition on the number A, or the number part of the standard form number. So take this number, 12.6 times 10 to the power of 9. That's a perfectly good number, but look at the 12.6. That is not between 1 and 10. That means that that number is not in standard form. And if you gave this as the answer on an exam question, where the answer needed to be in standard form, you would lose marks. We can fix this, however. So 12.6, well, that's equal to 1.26 times 10. So we can rewrite it in this form. Then laws of indices tell us that 10 times 10 to the power of 9 is 10 to the power of 10. So we can rewrite that number like this, 1.26 times 10 to the power of 10. 1.26 is between 1 and 10, and therefore, that number is in standard form. So how do we calculate with standard form numbers? Well, most of the time you're going to use your GDC for these calculations, but that of course means you need to make sure you're familiar with how your GDC handles and displays standard form numbers. For example, does it use standard form display, or does it use an AEK display? Like this. So that number there is the calculator's way of saying 1.25 times 10 to the power of negative 12. And that number there is the calculator's way of saying 1.568 times 10 to the power of 16. And if you're using a calculator like this, make sure you turn your answers into proper standard form when you write them down for an exam question. Otherwise, you can lose marks. Now, what's the entry method for standard form numbers? Some calculators will have an EE button that looks a bit like this. Some might have a times 10 to the power of X button that looks like this. So if you were entering the number 2 times 10 to the power of 9, you might hit the key for 2, then the EE key, then the 9 key. Or if you had a different calculator, it might be the 2, the times 10 to the power of X key, and then the 9 key. Now, scientific mode is something your calculator may have. These are modes where standard form may become the default or that handles calculations in certain ways. If you're going to use this type of mode on your GDC, you need to be familiar with how it works. And also, significant figures are something to look out for. So here is a calculation that's been put into the calculator. The calculator gives us this as the answer, and there are two things to note. First of all, that's not an exact answer. The exact answer is 6.44981412 times 10 to the power of 27. The calculator has already rounded it off to 6 significant figures. But for your answers, you're usually going to want 3 significant figures, so don't forget to round your answers. And also note that the 6.45 here, the number part of the standard form number, that's the only part you need to round to 3 significant figures. You don't need to do anything with the power of 10 part. And also note, it is possible to do standard form calculations by hand. If you're multiplying or dividing, it'll be helpful to remember laws of indices. If you're adding or subtracting them, then sometimes you can do it by writing them in full or by using matching powers of 10. And for details and examples of these by-hand methods, see the standard form revision note. Now for a quick recap. Standard form is a concise way of writing very large or very small numbers. A standard form number is written in the form A times 10 to the power of K, where A is between 1 and 10, and K is an integer. Different calculators handle and display standard form numbers in different ways, so make sure you're familiar with how your GDC works. Most calculations you do with standard form numbers will be done in your GDC. It is also possible, however, to do standard form calculations by hand. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.